Hi guys, welcome back. Well, I think there is one thing that we all have in common as hikers, and that's the ever ongoing wish list in regards to gear. And of course, I've got a wish list in regards to gear as well. And because the hiking community in the Netherlands isn't that large, especially not the hiking community for long distance hiking, multiple day hikings. So that means that I'm pretty limited in gear that I can get here in the Netherlands. And that means I have to import a lot, which costs, of course, a lot of money. And I do not have that every month in my bank account. So that means that my wish list keeps on growing. And well, I really have to save to get some things. And some things are on the wish list for a very long time, but are just too expensive. For example, this JetBoiler stash. It was on top of my wish list from the moment that it came out and that I saw the YouTube videos about it. And yeah, there was something about this item that really intrigued me and I wanted it straight away, but it is very expensive here in the Netherlands. It has to be imported, so that means that the retail price in the Netherlands is around €169.95, which is about $197. So that's almost $200. So that's absolutely insane. So it was on my wish list and it stood on my wish list until I started working at the outdoor store last month. And 2 weeks ago, we had a special day where we can buy whatever we wanted with a pretty decent discount. And of course, the JetBoiler stash was in our store. So no doubts for me, this was the item that I was going to buy. So finally, I've got my JetBoiler stash. So let's talk about my first impression today. And after that, I opened the package and gave my first impression on it. I'm going to compare it to the stove that I've been using for several years now, which is the Amazon Pocket Rocket, to see if I did the right thing buying it, that I think it is better than the Amazon Pocket Rocket, or do I maybe regret buying it, and will I be staying with the Amazon Pocket Rocket? We will find out. So I'm going to open the package now. Let's see what I think of this item. I have to open this one first. And here it is. Well, many of you have seen it, of course, on YouTube already, but I'll show it to you a little bit closer. The handle on top and the flux ring in the bottom. The flux ring, due to JetBoiler, will make sure that water boils faster and gas is being used more sparely. So we'll see if that's true. I'm going to open it by clicking the handle. And then everything is in the pot. This is really nice. You can clip the gas canister in the lid, and that's something I really like because I really can't stand the sound of the gas canister rattling in your pot all day long when you're hiking. So this is absolutely one thing I love. I liked it as well. This is just a sample, of course. This is not a full gas canister, but you can add a full gas canister in it. So I will try it in a few seconds. In here is also the stove itself. Comes in a nice handy pocket. Shows how you have to store it. And then here it is. Just click it open. See if I can open it like this. Now I will get a scissor in a few seconds. In here is also the pot stand, which you can clip open and put the gas canister in so it is a little bit more stable. And we have a starter user guide and information about the stash and the warranty that's on it. So my first impression on the pot itself is that it's absolutely lightweight. It doesn't weigh a lot at all. I will get my scissors and I will get the scale as well so I can weigh it. Just a second. So I've got everything now and I'm going to weigh the pot to see how much it weighs in total. And it weighs 126 grams, so that's a lightweight one. Not as light as the toques I have, if I'm saying it correctly, but I can try that because I have it next to me. And that one weighs 87 grams. So the JetBoiler stash is definitely not the lightest, but That doesn't matter. It's also about the convenience that it brings me, or at least I hope that it will bring me. The burner itself comes in at 58 grams. So let's move this aside. And the burner, it actually works pretty much the same as all the stoves. Let's see how this one exactly goes. You just fold it aside. And then you have a tree stand stove. Of course, we are going to adjust that to the gas canister. I just got a small one from Jetboil here. Of course, companies always say that you have to use their own brand, but my experience is that a Jetboil works just as fine with a MSR canister, and a MSR stove works just as fine with a Jetboil canister. So I don't think that really makes a huge difference. So I'm going to add this one to it, if it's willing to. There we go. Oh, it does not sizzle. my MSR pocket rocket always sizzles like crazy when I'm turning it on. So that's that. And then you can use the pot stand if you want to. Of course, if you're on a level ground, like a table like this, it's not absolutely necessary, but you know, a bit of safety when you're out is never a bad thing. So then we've got the stove here completed. I will put this one aside as well. I've got the lid here. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to get the MSR pocket rocket beside it, and then I'm going to compare the two of them. I'm going to boil the same amount of water. I've got two bottles of 350 milliliters of water here beside me, so I can compare it, because that is mainly the amount of water that I need for my dehydrating backpacking meal. So I think that was fair to test it out with that one. So I've got both stoves here in front of me, and there's also a difference that you notice straight away, and between the Toke pot that I'm using in a combination with my MSR pocket rocket, that has a closed lid, and this one has a plastic lid, the Jetboil, so you can see through it. And I think that's really nice, because those little handles can get pretty warm when water is boiling. So when you have to lift it all the time to check if the water is boiling, can be pretty hot. And this one you just put on and you can see straight through it. So that's a plus for me for the Jetboil. So I'm going to fill both up with 350 milliliters of water. These aside, take my phone with me for the timer to see how long both take. I will show you that, of course, in a second. And I'm going to light both stoves first. Okay, having to check that. 1 second. Turns out that the Jetboil doesn't work. First impression, huh? There we go. So both are on. I am about to start the timer. And let's see which one boils first. I've got both canisters fully open, so they are both burning on their highest. Let's check both. That's starting to come to a boil. And the Jetboil is already boiling at just a little over 1 minute. So let's turn that one off. MSR pocket rocket is still coming to a boil. almost. That's going over 1.5 minutes right now. One minute and 50 seconds. Well, that was a clear win for the Jet Boy, wasn't it? What I also really like about the Jet Boy is when I'm getting my toke spot and the handles get really warm, and I also put some isolation tape around it, but they still get pretty hot, so I always need something like a cloth like this to get my pot out of the stove. And the handle of the Jet Boil doesn't get even lukewarm, it's just cold, you don't feel anything. So that's absolutely a plus for me as well, because then I don't have to take a whole cloth extra to just put my pot off the stove. And what I also like about the Jet Boil is that the pot clips in those tiny, yeah, sort of teeth here, so that it stays firmly on it, and this one can easily move around on the stove. Someone is coming to say hi to you guys. Hello. So yeah, I think that that was clear. 1 minute for the Jet Boil and 1 minute 50 seconds for the Amazon Pocket Rocket, which is not bad at all, of course, but yeah, definitely the Jet Boy was quicker here. And of course, I am not in a place where we are at high elevation, and it is not cold today, so those are not factors that influenced the, yeah, should I say it, test that I just did. So what I will be doing with the Jet Boil, I'm going to switch out this whole cloth. I will cut a little round just in the size of the bottom of the pot from a sponge cloth, and I will put that in so I have at least something with me to clean out the pot, although I am usually only boiling water in it, so that's mainly just a matter of letting it dry while I'm eating. But just in case, I will put a little cloth in it, but I will or at least a sponge cloth, then this microfiber cloth can stay at home. Saves a little bit of weight, doesn't it? So I made the stove, I take it off the gas canister again, and now I'm going to see if I am able to fit everything in. On this little package for the little bag for the stove, you also have some sort of instructions how you should pack everything in. So I'm going to see if that works. This one shows how you should put the stove in. So that's the first thing we are going to do. Then they say, I think it's on here as well, yeah, then they say the pot canister goes in. You put this one to the side, and then you clip this one in here. You can also put a little lighter in between your gas canister and the lid, and that should be one of those big mini, and they have everything stuck together. So I'm going to see if that works. Actually does, it goes very easy. And then I close the lid, and my Jet Boil is all packed, ready to go. This was a brand new fuel canister, so it is completely full at the moment. So I'm going to see what the whole combination weighs. The whole combination comes in at 432 grams. So that's absolutely fine to have everything in it. It doesn't feel heavy at all. I think I'm going to be really, really happy with this stove. First impression is absolutely great. I love it. It boils absolutely fast. I mean, wow, just 1 minute to boil my water. That is so quickly. Not that the Amazon Pocket Rocket takes extremely long for it, but 1 minute, well, I think that's a record for what I have been using for the last years. So yeah, I think this is a great piece of kit. I absolutely do not regret buying it. And for what my first impression is now, I think this one is going out of the backpack, and this one is going in the 2022 backpacking season. Thank you for joining me with this video, and I would like to say, as always, enjoy the outdoors, and we will catch you on the next trail. Goodbye.